Hi girls and guys, I'm going to attempt a border pattern. I'm using a speed Lindsay 123 degree driver. I think you could use a 96, but with power assist you can get away with a wider grader, and you also this is where I tried it. Yeah, actually this boulder is from a Ken Hunt. I'll put a link in the description. So that's where I tried it, and up this end I used the 96 degree, and then I've used the 123, so you can see the difference, which is good and bad. I mean, this, when you use a wider graver, it gives us a lot of dimension, which I like, but the thinner graver is just nice and black and white, so that may be the better thing. And you see, in this side, I've got more contrast. I didn't join on, so I'll try and get the contrast. So you need a black and white, so this is what really makes hand engraving stand out. So I can't find, you probably need dividers to measure this out, but I've recently moved, I can't find anything, so I'm just going to do it by eye, so, which is okay. I think a lot of hand engraving is like production work. They don't spend too much time measuring it. I read old books and things like that, and they talk about borders, and they don't say measure them, they just say you get an idea. So I'm using a microscope, so if I'm off a quarter of a millimetre, it won't really show. Right, so here you go, I did a line to start with, so a straight line and then some dots. So the first stage is to engrave lines to those dots at 90 degrees to the first line you engrave. I'll do I'll do a few now. I'll point out, now I don't do it all the time. See, so I'll cut this line. Now you see the I don't know if you can see it, the face of the graver is parallel to the surface of the metal, so you're cutting a nice V. What I tend to do is lean my hand over. It's just a habit. Well, it's a thing I've got in my wrist. It wants to turn over all the time, so I forget sometimes. But I'm concentrating now. So nice straight V's. Right, let me change to a 96 degree and I'll do a couple of lines in that. Mm-hmm. You say, oh, you see, so it's nice and black there, they're showing up black. So I'd say the 96 creates a thinner, blacker line. So if that's the look you want, then that's what you should go for. Not a lot of difference. Right, so there's a little row of fence posts. And I mean, you'll see the, I've got to refer back to the picture now. You'll see what I'm doing. The next stage is to put a little diamond thing on the top. So I imagine this is not the way it was really done, because this was designed for hand pushing graving, and The advantage with a power assist is you can dive in out, in the cut and out the cut. So I described that, I called that technique star practice. So you're making little stars. And you can see there, let me show, so I'm going backwards and forwards to the picture. So see, some of them look really good, but that's a good thing. It's just practice. You'll find that you won't get it quite right. I'd suggest I'm going to analyse it now. So hold it quite high. So there's the graver normally. So you're diving down and then drop your wrist. If you see the star practice, you'll know why. Drop your wrist. Oh, it's got a nice point on that one. See how nice that is. And obviously you want them all the same, so these aren't good, so I'd have to go back in and sort them out. But, right, they won't match perfectly, but I'm just showing you the technique as I see it. It's interesting, the more you get into engraving, you can look at old engraving, you can analyse it, and you can kind of guess how they did it. Right, this is going back to the 96 degree. So you see, you can't dive down as much and make a you might like one more than the other, but don't worry about it, it doesn't look that black, but we'll put paint in it. But these are coming up really black, but maybe I'll sharpen the graver differently, finer. Right, the next stage is so we're going to make a little triangle in between our little fence posts. Now I would imagine, I did experiment, and you wouldn't do it like this without a power assist. Maybe not, but so basically it's my wide graver again I've changed to, and you're just diving down, and because you've got that line cut already, and the metal is going to give away. But this part is it's good practice, because right now the chip, let me zoom in and I'll explain what I'm doing. So right, actually this when I meant to mention it, but then I forgot when I was doing the style practice one, it's about metal fatigue. See that little bit of metal hanging on? So the trick with engraving is you've got to break them bits of metal off without damaging the line. So the line, where I cut away the line, makes the bit of metal weaker, so that helps you, but then you don't want to bump into it. But you probably are going to do now and again, and I do. But and then if you do it badly, you can just recut the line a bit wider. So I'm holding the graver up quite high. Oh, you can see the face now. So there's the metal, see it? See, it's just going in the trough of that. Now I'm dropping my wrist, and then, oh, that come out really nice. Yeah, it's a perfect square. And then pink, just let me analyze the last bit. I can't describe a lot. It's kind of up and forward, but I know I used to do it myself. You'll do it, and then you'll do a scratch up here, but don't worry about it. It's just, you do it 100 times and then you'll, or 1,000 times, and then you won't scratch it as much. You still scratch it. So let's get on with that. And see, you don't really need to measure these things out, or if you feel like you do, then do. That's fine. Because once you do it once with a measurement, you'll be more confident to do it without. But you know, if you do it perfect and you measure it, then it's even better. So right, so I'm going to change to the 96 degree. And that would translate, if you're using my template, so that, oh, I've gone way off there. My twitchy hands just, see that, I can't always control where the graver starts. Oh, not bad. So same principle, but slightly different feel. Oh, they're nice and triangular though. Right. So then we're going to make some little leaves. And this looks really nice with the wider graver. So I'm now back to the wider one, the 123. And so the way... Oh, right. So you do these a couple of times, and you'll... Like, I did these a bit bunched up. So then there's a bit that I couldn't fit in. So now I'm going to remember that I've got to make some room. And let me just... I might perfect it as I go down the line. What I did, I prefer it this way. So this is because we're using power assist, we can change it slightly, which is give it some dimension. So I am actually leaning the graver over a little bit, which I'm not sure. Oh, there's a slip. Right, let's concentrate. So you imagine once you got used to it, and you got a rhythm, you could do a really nice and you can apply this to a circle. So if you were doing coins, it really adds a lot if you do a border on a coin. So whatever design you're doing, you just scribe a line around it and you can do it off of that. Let me change, right, I'm gonna change to the 96 now. See what that looks like. I think it might work better with a 96 in some respect because it'll give me more room for the next part. So yeah, you can see the difference now. So I'm kind of liking this side now, the thinner one, because right, and then there's a little, right, so you just go over the top of your little diamonds down the bottom. I'm gonna leave this here because I use the wider graver, there's not enough room, but yeah, I realized just a little fine line, it looks like, just over the top of your little diamond and the yeah, I'm not sure about. I might draw it out and experiment again, but it's it just describes a border is just like a series of cuts, and then when they're all done, it looks really impressive. So I'm going to try one in there. There's a little bit more. I've left myself a little bit more room on that. So now I'm going to change back to the. to the 123 and see if I can fit. And you can see how easy it would be to make your own border. You just you think of a design that's repeatable, repeatable cuts. No, it don't really work. Yeah. Don't really work with a wider graver this part. So maybe if you did all the rest with the wider graver, you'd change back to a thinner one. Oh yeah, right. Now I'll leave the last two so you can see, and I will give it a tiny polish. Just it shows up a bit better. But the idea, most like this, is based on the old English hand engraving. I don't think they ever sanded it back. It would be it's kind of production work, so they wanted to get it done. And I'll put some paint in it. I don't think they ever put paint in it either, but I don't know. I'm guessing. Oh, the first one they did don't look too bad now. Oh, it looks like a nice row of railings, doesn't it? So that was the first one. It's not too bad, that. But you can see, so, right, close up. Looks all right, doesn't it? But they're not that even and all that. But this is the thing with hand engraving. So you can see the thinner one was better in the end because it gave me more room. And then we've got black and white. That's the way. That's the beauty of hand engraving, or what really stands out. This one, you see, it's a bit squashed up. In fact, if I polish that back slightly, it would come back. It would put the contrast back into it. So I'm going to go to this is a 400. I wouldn't normally do this, but oh, killed it. Oh dear. See what I mean about? Oh, that really overdid it. I should have went to a finer. Brush. So you can polish your engraving a little bit, but you'll notice yourself if you ever do it. I got away with that anyway, but without the paint it looked awful. It's like all rounded over to me. Oh yeah, but you can see it did bring back the contrast, so it just lowered the cuts I did, so it brought that white back. Right, so this is what I'll take the macro off, so now you're going to see it more as you would with an eight. So that's quite impressive. If it was a bit more careful, yeah, it's quite nice. And it's only so what's there? So the bottom one's inches and the top one's millimeters. Oh, sorry about that. Oh yeah, and this is the coin I did on style practice, so if you remember that. So that's the same, you are using a lot of the same technique, so that's what I said. If you just practice that technique, it will help you with this kind of thing. You could actually make a transfer of that. I mean, if you would only need lines, and then it's perfectly measured. Right, guys and girls, hope that helps. Yeah, you could do a lot with that, couldn't you? I probably will do that on a coin. I'll try and put that in the coin next one I do. Let me see how it goes. Cheers, everybody. Bye.